Okay, so I create AI models or AI influencers, and I make them more popular than your average real life human influencer. And this is truly the future, and I'm going to talk about this today and a little bit about how you can even get started in this space. So, who the fuck am I? I am Kyle. I have 3 years' experience in OnlyFans management. Essentially, where you take an OnlyFans model, you manage their socials, you build them up as almost like an influencer character, and then you can manage their OnlyFans page to make money from that. And I also have two years' experience in the artificial intelligence OnlyFans management realm. Now, I was the first one in this space. Again, 2 years ago, a lot of you probably hadn't even heard of AI or know what the fuck AI even is. However, in the last 2 years, I have been building up AI-generated influencers and essentially monetizing that online and then making shit tons of money. And yes, I have been talking about this literally since the start of the journey. You can go back on this channel 2 years ago, I've been talking about the same shit. So yeah, I do this for a living. I consider myself an expert in this space. So what is an AI influencer? Essentially, AI models are now more than just digital avatars. They're not just cartoon people on a screen. They are literally the future of the influencer kind of landscape. Not only are they more popular, a lot of them, but they are able to mimic exactly what a real human influencer would be able to do online. And with the right strategies, AI models can be a lot more effective than real influencers in the fact that they can operate 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Real influencers, I don't know if you've ever met any, but they don't tend to be the most hardworking individuals. Sorry to stereotype. But yeah, AI, you can hire a team to make content and they don't need rest, they don't exist. So there has been a huge surge in numbers in the AI influencer space, and particularly, versus the growth of real influencers, AI influencers have been performing very, very well in the last couple of years. So, building the model. What is your process when building the model? So, step one, you want to choose a persona. So this can include things like hobbies, a niche that she fits into, location, and is she innocent, super dirty, what's she like? So I'm going to delve into just a few of these. Of course, there's more into building a persona than just this, but these are just some examples. So hobbies, what's she actually into? Does she like to travel? Does she like to play golf? What are her interests? What are her hobbies? These are essential when someone wants to kind of engage with an influencer's content. So we have to kind of re-engineer this into, from the very beginning, what is our AI model? Into what does she or he enjoy doing with their day? Niche. Now, this is slightly different to hobbies, however, it can be related. So, a niche can be something like just a random example. They can be a MILF, right? That's their niche. They're, an older female. That's kind of a niche they fit into. However, it's not a hobby. However, a niche can be a hobby. For example, football or soccer. So that can also be a niche, as well as obviously that's an interest as well. Location. So not only where were they born? So for example, they were born in London, but where do they choose to base themselves as an adult now? Are they based in New York? That can tell you a lot about someone's personality just by where they're based and where they choose to base themselves. And innocent slash super dirty, that's more to do with the sex industry version of the AI influencer space. However, it's very important when determining someone's persona. And there's a lot more elements to this as well, which I'm not going to go into now, but many videos on the channel to do with persona and things like this. Step two will be creating the visuals. So this is actually designing your model. Now, if you're a complete beginner, you don't know anything about AI, I recommend using Genfluence. It's the easiest. Most beginner friendly, it's good quality, and it's the cheapest platform that you're going to find for that quality. Genfluence, super easy to use. Just, yeah, create a model on there and you'll be fine. But things to consider: hair color, body type, fashion style. These are just some things that I can name that you may want to consider when actually doing the creation process of your AI model. And number three is crafting the socials. So does she have an Instagram page? Most likely, because Instagram is the fastest growing social media platform and the easiest to grow on, in my opinion. You want to consider color schemes and aesthetics. So let's say your model had like a pink aesthetic to her Instagram page. You're going to get a completely different vibe from her if she was to differentiate herself via a black themed Instagram page. That might be more slightly gothic or emo vibe, whereas pink, you get super girly kind of very feminine vibes from that. And any kind of alternate social media, so Pinterest, Twitter, LinkedIn, fucking anything, YouTube, you can do any of these and you can make AI videos, so YouTube is not a problem anymore. And of course your monetization method, because this is going to determine one of two things, which I'm going to go over very, very soon. So marketing your model. There are a lot of marketing methods you can use your model, including not limited to even such as email marketing, SMS marketing. However, that's kind of outlandish, right? That's not really mainstream. However, things that are very, very simple to get into and understand are Instagram and TikTok, because they are extremely viral, extremely easy to grow when you know what to do on them. Now, using popular sounds and simple kind of viral trends is going to give you a lot of engagement. And then bringing those fans to an Instagram page and then engaging them via stories, lifestyle content, making them engage through polls, questions, Q&As, anything like this is going to increase the watch time on that model from a specific viewer. So very, very useful. So customers will be drawn to this content, and anywhere where there is attractive girls is not only other girls or, you know, just women trying to watch this content, but also mainly important for monetization methods is horny men. So monetization, I'm not going to touch on this too much. There's so much on this channel about monetization. However, there are two routes for monetization, and one is going to be your spicy pages. So OnlyFans, just an example, everyone knows what OnlyFans is, although most likely you're going to want to use FanView, or your clean methods. This can be brand deals or getting paid via any kind of social media ad revenue program. So TikTok have a great one. I believe the average CPM on TikTok is like $1 per 1,000 views, which is very, very easy to achieve. And if you are in that creator program, then easy money for sure. However, what's going to bring us really, really good money is these spicy platforms. This is my favorite way to monetize AI models. Not that I particularly enjoy spending time on this platform. However, it is amazing in terms of money. And sure, the idea of having an AI influencer which gets loads of brand deals and, you know, she does Nike photo shoots and all this kind of shit sounds brilliant. But to get to that level, you have to have such a large audience, and, you know, it's really, really complex to kind of get to that level. And it gets to a point where brands such as Nike, you know, big brands have to consider whether they can even legally use AI models. Sounds stupid, but for some reason, there are certain laws prohibiting this to do with kind of models' rights or actors' rights or some shit like that. So how do AI models outperform real influencers? And is this always the case? I'm going to answer that one first. And the answer to that is no, not always the case, of course. If you have a massive influencer, I can't even think of one off the top of my head, but Mr. Beast, let's just say Mr. Beast because he's fucking huge. Could that be replicated by artificial intelligence? Not exactly. There's certain things, obviously, in Mr. Beast content which would prohibit that from being an AI model. However, these are some ways that AI models do outperform real influencers, and on a general scale, AI models will outperform real influencers. However, the top end influencers will most likely, at least for the next couple of years, stay as real influencers, because AI has some hindrances in terms of technology. So consistency, Obviously, an AI model can work 24 hours a day. You can hire a team to make them work 24 hours a day. So there's no breaks required for an AI model. You know, they don't need sleep. They don't need fucking downtime. They don't need to watch Netflix, anything like this. So extremely consistent in terms of content production and everything around the clock. Automation, similar kind of process. So you can automate even content generation. You can automate your social media posting. You can schedule loads of shit using actual artificial intelligence or different softwares, or just outsourcing and using staff. Very simple. Whereas, you know, real influencers, they're going to have their phone in their hand and they're actually going to be doing this shit. Not always, but most of the time. Customization. Now, this is a very important kind of point to bring up, because you can customize them fully. A real human has to be born. You know, I have to spend 9 months being fucking born. Whereas an AI influencer can literally just be teleported into existence at the age of 18 years old and ready to make content. Not only this, but she or he, I'm going to use she. She can look exactly however you want. So she can have fucking pink hair. She can have an alien shaped head. She can be as slim as you like unhumanly slim. Whereas, you know, real people are real people. They have limits in that respect. And also, not only customization in terms of looks, but customization in terms of location, and yeah, everything to do with that. So they can be anywhere in the world at any time. Of course, you can 1 minute be in New York, 1 minute be in Paris. Doesn't matter. And margins, well, these influencers don't exist. So the profit that they make is all yours. You're not going out and managing OnlyFans girls or managing influencers and they take a cut. You're completely taking 100% of this, you know, minus any work that you're outsourcing. So if you are outsourcing a team to make this content, if you are outsourcing a team to run marketing for you, of course there are expenses. But in terms of marginal split with the influencer does not exist. Couple tips for aspiring AI model creators. Excuse the quality on this picture, it's awful, but this is Emily Pellegrini. Her content's not great, but she makes a lot of money. People love stories, and people love realism. Stories and realism kind of go hand in hand. So even stories that are boring, such as, you know, I went to the shops today, for some reason it's engaging to an audience. You may see influencers just chat shit about absolutely pointless stuff, which affects no one's life. And people just engage with it because they like that person. So build a personality that people can engage with and people can almost, you know, fall in love with, especially if you're going for the OnlyFans route. You want people to fancy this model. You want people to engage in that way. Another tip is to change it up, because everyone has this fucking blonde hair, blue eyes, slim AI model. And although they are, you know, the greatest assets on earth to exist, no bias, it's not always the correct route to go. You know, spice it up. Make her have bright green eyes with blue hair. You know, just spice it up. That may not sell as well, that particular example, but you can think of some differentiating characteristics which could perform very, very well. Now, if you are interested in this business model and interested in learning how to create AI models, how to build them up on social media, and then how to monetize them via spicy websites such as OnlyFans and FanView, I have a $47 AI model method course. We have tons of students doing very, very well, and also a community full of students which you will have access to as a student yourself. So if you are looking to network with people who are pursuing this business model, as well as this, we also have hundreds and hundreds of videos on this channel teaching you exactly how to build AI models and then how to monetize that content. $47, I mean, it's a no-brainer. It's cheaper than a night out. It's cheaper than getting a fucking takeaway. It's cheaper than a divorce with your shit wife. And it's cheaper than any other online course that I can think of off the top of my head. With any real value, of course. I'm sure there's some $1 shitty courses built by Indian people. But yeah, in terms of a valuable course in a growing industry that no one really knows about, AI model method course is your go-to. So check that out. It will be in the description, and it's only $47 for now. So go grab it while you can.